Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to talk about if else then statement. I will go through these statements one by one. And first of all, I would like to explain about if statement. So if a statement is actually basically used to perform when you are interested in subsetting any data set. For example, I have a data set here. You can see that. So when I will run that, it will create a data set name exam. So it has like, you know, three variables, name, class, and score. And it has like, you know, so many different values are actually included there. So suppose if I want to subset a data set where I'm interested in only name Tim. So for that, I can use like this kind of a statement. You can see here. So I can write this statement if name is equal to Tim. So remember, when you are using any character value, you have to hard code it. You have to put quotation mark here, you know, at the starting at the end of the value. So when you run this program, you will get only a data set where name is Tim. So you can see that this is subset is created. So this is how you can use if condition. So suppose I am interested in another data set where I have to basically generate, you know, a data set where a score is basically 9, you know, or greater than 9. So you can write like, you know, score is greater than or equal to 9, and you can use like multiple operators here. You know, I explained you in my previous video like how you can use operators. So when you run this program, what you will get, that you will get a data set where a score is 9 or greater than 9. So you can see that. So this is how you can generate a subset of data set. So this is the first use of when you are using if statement only. So now I'm moving to the if then delete statement. So here I'm using then and delete as well. So for example, you wanted to create a data set where you want to delete, you know, name Tim records actually. So for example, if you have data, you know, where you are not interested in records from the name with Tim. So how you can do that? So for that, you have to write a condition here, like if name is equal to Tim. So this is again hard coded because this is a character value, and then you have to write delete. So when you run this program, what will happen? All the records with the name Tim will be deleted and the rest of the data will appear. So you can see that, you know, you can see that name Tim is actually deleted from the record. So this is how you can use if then delete statement. And the third one is like if then else statement. So this is very, you know, interesting to understand that. So here you have to look about true condition. One condition is true and other is not true. Like that means it's false. For example, you know, I have the same data set, you know, here you can see the scores, class, and name, and I'm giving a condition here, like, you know, if score is less than or equal to 8, then status is average. So what I'm doing, that if it is 8 or less than 8, so the student is average, and I'm giving another statement, else status is equal to high. So that means if the first condition is true, that will assign, you know, the status variable as average. And else condition, when the first condition is not true, then it will assign the status as a high. So if condition is true, then perform the action. So it will perform the action. And else, like perform the action when the condition is false, that means the first condition is not true. So this is, you know, simple. And when I run this program, you can see in the first condition score is 9, that assigned as a high in the status variable. So you can see that, you know, if 8 or less than 8, it assigned as an average. But if it is more than 8, like 9 or 10, it status value is assigned as a high. So this is how you can write if then else statement. So fourth statement is if then else if statement. So this statement is very important to understand, because when you are giving multiple statement and multiple condition, you have to understand that where you have to use if statement and else if statement. So for example, the first statement, if you are using, then you have to write if statement. So when condition is true, then it will perform this action. And second, you have to write else and then if statement again. So this will perform when the second condition is true. It will not overwrite the previous condition. And the same likewise, the third condition. So else you are writing and then you are writing if. So this will perform the action when third condition is true. It will not overwrite the previous conditions. So for example, this is very easy to understand that why else is important to write in every if statement, after the first if statement. So you can see I have a data set, and this data set has 4 variables, 4 columns and 9 rows and 9 records are there. So I'm giving a condition here, for example, generating another subset of data and read in 1 actually, and I'm giving condition here if ID is suppose less than 75. So ID is less than 74, for example 70, 45 and 25. So 3 records are there for that. Then I'm assigning tag as old. And if I am writing another if statement where ID is less than 100, I'm assigning, tag as a new. And if ID is greater than or equal to 100, then tag variable should be unchecked. So this is my, program I wrote here. So you can see that what will happen, that when you write this statement, first if statement, it will assign, the tag as old. But when you write, this program will run, so this will update your, program when ID is less than 100. So it will overwrite the previous program of the if statement. So what will happen, you can see that when you run this program, you will see that, here ID is less than 70, and but your tag is coming new. Ideally, it should be old actually for this and this, for 3 records. But because this is a new statement, and this will considering, the statement as a fresh, and it will go back and look all the data set, it will check all the data set. If any value of ID which is less than 100, that should assign a tag value as a new. So for to prevent that, you have to write else statement here. So what else statement will do, it will not overwrite the previous statement. So the first statement is only with if, and the second is with else if. So here we are adding else, so it will not overwrite the previous statement. So when I will run this program, you can see that the value of ID 70 is assigned as old 45, as it was intended by intended for to create like that actually. So this is how you have to use else if statement, for using multiple statements for the multiple conditions. So this is very important to understand. The last thing and the fifth part, I just wanted to explain you about if then do statement. So this is also very important when you are actually using a block of statements or multiple statements from one condition. So suppose I am creating if ID is less than 100, then I want to create 3 different variables, tag 1, 2, 3. I'm assigning these values. So this I have to do statements always end with end statement. So this is how you can write the program. So what it will do, that you can write multiple statement here and create multiple variables, and the same you have to write else statement so that it will not overwrite the previous one. And then you have to give the condition here, then do. So you can assign like multiple statements block here, and you can write the end statement to complete this loop. So this is how you can write multiple statements from one conditions. So you have to use if then do statements for that. So I'm going to run this program for for easy understanding, and you can see that 3 variables were generated and they all assigned a value based on conditions given there. So this is how you can use if then do statements. So these statements are very important to understand, and I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for watching.